Hello, friends. Oh God, Wokji. Yeah, Wokji. Sunny, thanks for the 14 months. Oh, a stray bang. As per usual. Do you see chat? Yes, I do. Oh God. Oh, you know what? It's because I keep taking night showers and then I go outside and I feel the wind in my hair and then it's messy forever. Nitro Jet, thanks for 10 months. Thank you, thank you. Don't cut. No, I'm gonna let the little silly bangs grow out for sure. You know, it's definitely been a... Hi, hello. Hello. This song is perfect. Thank you for playing it. I like that song a lot too. I forgot what it was called. And so today I typed in Google song that goes and I was like, I'm just never gonna know what this song is because I was like, I don't know what I was expecting, but like nothing was showing up. I don't know. Everyone does it, not just me, but I was hoping that maybe I would get really lucky. And then I was like, oh my God, piano guy, the guy that sings piano, what's his name again? And then I found it. Yeah, so you know. Yeah, I did it. Elton John, yeah, it took me a while. Oh God. Listen, I just definitely didn't grow up listening to Elton John, I think. Are you ever gonna play Among Us again? I haven't been very active on socials, but I noticed there aren't any vids anymore. Wait, that's interesting. That means you kind of know me more from YouTube then, if that's what you're saying. Because I definitely haven't posted anything in quite some time. Yuzion, thanks for the 10 months. A.F. Kennedy, thanks for the 25 months. 2 years and a month. No, I've told you guys, it does give me whiplash when someone says they like my videos. And I'm like, ooh, but I'm like a streamer. Videos. What videos? Oh, God. What? This one just wants to stay in the middle. It literally is that way. Oh man, I have to like train it or something. This is terrible. Oh God. Tina's fave kitten. Thanks for the 10 months. Tina Morning Lobby. Oh good heavens, guys. Oh good heavens. I just wish I could erase everything I know from Among Us. You know? Like kerplunk. And then maybe it would make it a lot more fun, but I feel like I just know too much now. I think my hair just dried wet like that. Yes. You should at least do one vlog a day. That's really hard. People that do daily vlogs are different. Really different. Maybe playing with people you haven't played before. Mila asking for Among Us? Interesting. C flats, thanks for the 6 months. Thank you. Yeah, dude, why not? Let's try one vlog a year. That would be good. That would be a good start. At least once every 6 months. I feel like daily is a little ambitious, you know? You should post another TikTok. I'll just post the draft that I did before that one. It's the exact same thing. Joe Monrock says the tier 3 for 2 months. What the heck? Thank you. Thanks. I'm not doing that. It's the exact same thing. Except, actually, I looked at it. Oh my goodness. I looked at it and actually my, blink was more on time and more crispy. Oh God. My bangs are misbehaving. Oh. Like, what is this? Yeah, that'll do them. Oh God. Do you like Cupid? I do like Cupid. Oh God. Oh, heavens. These are, like, broken. It's like they dunked them in paint. I meant one day as in you should vlog sometime soon, not do a vlog every day. Oh, God. Sorry, Blair. Eh. Oh, God. My hair's just not the same. It's, like, all chopped up now. I also just have no sense of symmetry. Like, what is this? I've given up. I've had enough. Ugh. Klez, thanks for the 5 months. Thank you. I don't know what I want to do today, but I knew that I wanted to go live a little bit today. Because what did you think of Coachella this year? I got really scared of, like, the sheer amount of dust, I'm not gonna lie. So, I didn't go. There, I admit it. I didn't go because I was like, oh, it's dusty, and everybody says that it's really difficult, and I didn't have an outfit. Try to Riz. What are you saying? Wait, what Riz? What do you mean, try to Riz? What does that mean? No la entiendo nada, pero la amo. What does that mean? You don't understand, but you love something? Soupy Toad, thanks for the 6 months. Riz, charismatic. You, me! Ah! Thanks. Thank you. That's so nice. Even though you don't understand me? Oh my God, love knows no bounds. I'm so warm, and I used to be able to just turn on the AC, but I don't understand how this house works. I just go to sleep no matter what temperature it is. And I'm like really warm now. Sweating up a storm. Because every time I talk to you guys, I get really nervous and I start sweating. I'm sorry. You know, Tina, why are you the only one that calms my panic attacks? Not even my family can calm them down. I don't know the answer to that question. Maybe it's one of those situations where I'm not directly talking to you and interacting with your state of the world and mind. And maybe it takes you out of it, you know? It's like distracting. Maybe. Maybe it takes you out of it. You know what I mean? That kind of thing. I don't know, maybe that's like a... Because like sometimes, this is not the same thing, but I know if I'm feeling a certain way... I love you, Aurora, you're being loud. Sometimes when I talk to someone with a completely different state of mind, like foolish maybe, I'll be like, oh, that was really dumb, yeah, so you're so right. And then my mind will like kind of zap out of it because he'll just give me an answer that doesn't almost like... validate my irrational feelings at the moment. You know what I mean? Christina, thank you for the 18 months. Oh my goodness. More. I'm like, maybe it's something kind of like that. A little bit. Just a little bit distracting. Like a little bit. Maybe. Tina, what should I draw? You should draw... Maybe yourself, self-portrait. Alex, hello, Tina. Hello. Hi there. Hi. I'm merely hanging today. Merely hanging out. Listening to Aurora. And stream! It's been 11 minutes. I just started. Like I could. It is kind of early, so it's not like anything bad would happen. Possible. It's within the realm of possibility. BRB Tina, gonna do chores? Okay. Have fun doing chores. I did chores today. Lots of them. Well, I'm unpacking right now. Yeah, I have lots of... There's boxes everywhere. So many boxes. Oh. You know, I need to start making playlists because I can't have my shower music mixing in with, like, all my other tunes. You know what I mean? It's just, it throws off my flow a little bit. Oh my god, there's a bug in my room. Let's see. Hold on. What do you guys want to... Ooh, let's listen to Paprika. I love Paprika. Okay. Alright, perfect. What kind of music do you listen to in the shower? Dude, like anything. A little hodgepodge, you know? But, Tina, it's cold in LA. It's actually perfect weather right now. Perfect. Like, perfect. It's amazing. Paprika? Who's Paprika? It's a song by Japanese Breakfast. Wicked Witch, thanks to 8 months. Let's see. It's so cold in Michigan. What color should I dye my hair? Maroon. Like a deep burgundy. Have you read Crying in H Mart? I haven't, but I really want to. I think it would make me sad. In the same way that maybe Everything Everywhere All at Once would make me sad too. It's Bimo, thanks for the 2 months. What is maroon? It's red, but like a deep red. Rojo, right? What's that behind you? It's a screen divider until I get like curtains or something. Cause without it, it just looks kind of like jail in my room. A little bit. Oh. Smiles, thanks for the 8 months. Thank you. Oh my god, wait, I don't know if I can even use my iPad because I don't know if it's connected to the Wi-Fi. Aw, wait, I have to ask my roommate for the Wi-Fi password. Bro, what's the Wi-Fi password? Sophie, thanks for the gifted. Thank you, Monty. Thanks for the tier one. Do you play Animal Crossing? I did, especially at the height of the pandemic. I remember when it came out around March or April of like early 2020 or whatever. I just haven't been using the Wi-Fi. Maya, thanks for the 13 months. Thank you. But it's just, you know, it's because, guys, listen, I'm as of late, I'm a little unplugged. Like, you know, disconnect to connect, you know what I mean? Like, I've been enjoying the sunshine, feeling the wind in my hair, that kind of thing. Today I organized the pantry, and it was so fun, because it felt like Tetris, but in real life. I was like, this shape obviously needs to be this way. And I would like, and then I would like have the labels facing forward. And like, I don't know. It's just so satisfying. Actually, Abby, thanks for the 10 months. Yeah. It was kind of nice. Sounds like everything in life. What? Like what? Tina? What did I do? Like the unpacking game? Yeah, like the unpacking game. I kind of wish I went live a little bit earlier. Just a little bit. Because, I have to go soon. Bambi's crazy. Thanks for the 5 months. Thank you. Sanity, thanks for the tier one. I know it's literally just been, like, 16 minutes. Girl, I know. I listen. I can't wake up anymore. I keep like waking up at 2 p.m. But every day I try so hard. I have alarms that go off at 10. And then they go off every 10 minutes. And I still don't wake up. I'll wake up like this. And then I'll go on my phone. And I'll literally fall asleep as I'm scrolling on my phone. What am I supposed to do about that? Sanity, these are the tier one. Thank you. Tanita, my house? Yeah. And then I wake up. I crawl out at like 12:30. It's so bad. But then it makes me really tired by the end of the day. Yeah. Well, kind of, because I have class. Ooh, she's educated. Swiftwing, thanks for the 22 months. Thank you, thank you. Let's see. Oh, what to do? I wonder. Oh. Interesting. Yeah, maybe we can draw a little. Honestly, maybe we can get some real good stuff out of the way. You know what I mean? Like, maybe this is good for us. I truly believe so. No! What is this? Okay, I'm logging in. Yeah, it's probably doodle time. Or we can study too. Holy, it immediately opened up to my study guide. That's crazy. Hold on. Did I do it? More emotes? Yeah, we totally could, honestly. And now I wonder. God, my hair is so dumb. Okay. Let's see. You're late again? That's okay. That's totally fine. Danae, thanks for the 5 months. Love you, Tina. I'm so happy you come into my life. Ah, thanks. What the heck? That's so nice. You touched grass today. It was nice. Yeah, it can be kind of refreshing sometimes. I agree. Okay, let's see. Now let me check one thing. Oh. Interesting. Okay. 1 second. Oh my God, it's just so much. What is all this? So what? I'm just. God, I hate moving sometimes because then I always just have to change everything. I should have done this off stream. You know? Ugh. Like, why? I don't even know how to fix this. Jack Stauber. I want to listen to ABBA there. I said it there. I have selfish desires. Ugh. Hola, Tina Gatito. Hola. Mi nombre es Tina. Okay, wait. I think it's this. Oh, good heavens. Okay, now how do I make it stay this way? Oh my God. Why? Well, now this is just embarrassing. It's been like 21 minutes and I don't have anything to do. Usually I'm pretty good at, like, you know, making stuff up on the go, but this is just unacceptable. Woo, 17 months. Grim, thank you for the 17 months. Thank you, thank you. Create beats. This is the 3 months. Thank you. React. This is fun, just chilling. I know, but like, maybe you want, like, you know, some pleasant visuals or something. You know, like, in a way, like, we're all iPad kids, you know? I don't know. I'm just thinking. Oh, man. Okay. What the hell is this? I'm so upset. This is ridiculous. It's just not working. Oh, okay, you know what? Banned. No more. I'm gonna have to figure it out off stream. Are you using a different mascara? I'm using the same one, but I just... So, what I do when I go outside is I wear half makeup. Oh, banned from chat. Banned? What? Banned what? What do you mean? Oh, God. So, I wear half makeup outside because who's wear... I don't have... I just want to go outside quickly so I don't wear a full face. And then when I stream, I just put makeup on top of it. And so then I have like double layers of mascara right now. You know? Two layers. Oh, it was a play on words. You said the iPad is banned. Oh. I see. Tina Tub. Oh, yeah. Let's see. Guys, I can't just say everything because I'm not really going to know what you're saying. Well, great. Like, what am I supposed to do now? What am I supposed to do? I really just... I had so many plans, theoretically, and now I don't. Okay, well, Meatball Valo... You think so? Ooh, chatting. Plink, plink. Yeah, I could just chat. Oh, you guys want to see something that Xbox gave me? Have you guys seen The Mandalorian? Okay. All right. They gave me a little Grogu controller. He comes with a little blankie. Hold on. I'm wrapping him up. I'm sorry, it takes me a while. This is really cute. It's pretty cute, isn't it? It has a little... It comes with a little jacket. And you can take the jacket off. And it's just a really... It's a sage green controller. But then you can put the little jacket back on. Ugh. I play dress up with my Xbox controller. And then he has a little blankie that he comes with. Yeah, it's pretty cute. Thank you, Xbox. It's pretty cute. Like, even the controller without the clothes on is really cute. It's like a really cute color, but it does come with clothes, which is really funny. It has like armholes. It's so stylish. And then also one time, OPI, you know, like the nail polish brand. They also sent me nail polish and this purple Xbox controller as well. They're my favorite Xbox controllers. It's pretty cute. Oh, geez. My spine just snapped in a million pieces. I just finished my coffee. Tres leches flavor. It literally is show and tell. And on my desk, I have several bras that I have put onto my desk because it is the first thing that comes off when I press end stream. And then also, World of Warcraft gifted me this leather-bound book, amongst other things. It's awesome. It's a little ribbon here. I feel like a lot of you guys would like this. Like, people that really like lore and stuff. slightly yellowed pages. Right? Sometimes I just... Yeah, it does smell like... It does smell like... Like woods and stuff. I mean, it's literally like... So thank you, World of Warcraft. And then I just wrap it around like so. I haven't written anything in it yet. Yeah, there is a ghost. Oh god. And then on my desk I have some dirty plates that I ate Costco macarons on. What do I have here? I don't know. Yeah. Ghost? Here's my spray for my face that I don't really use, but I will just try it out from a distance. It's just such a fine mist, but like I think I sprayed it way too close last time. Yeah. Yeah, smile dog. Yeah. And then let's see. Flashbacks, yeah. Awesome sauce. Prada. And then I have a bunch of books that Brooke let me borrow that I've only read the first page of. The only time I started reading those books is when our power went out, specifically right after I died in Squid Game. And I went upstairs and I couldn't connect to the internet or anything, so I just read books with her in my Squid Game outfit. So post Squid Game, I was lying on the couch with my little outfit on reading. Yeah. And then some books maybe. Oh god, what is this? No, that's too much work. I'm not getting those. It is show and tell time right now, isn't it? I have some cat ears. Real Tina Michi style. These are special because they're the first ears I've ever gotten gifted to me from a friend. I need to stop drinking this. There's nothing in here. The dream is dead. Hold on. Oh. Yes. They have ribbons, but also they have little carrot attachments as well. Which I'm going to have to find because the movers took out all my stuff. And usually they don't do that, I feel like. Yeah. Cream pudding, thanks for the tier one. Oh my god, my bangs need to stop drying that way. It matches the shirt. Yeah, it is just a little pink shirt today. It's because, well, I was gonna wear like a sweatshirt, but then like it's so warm now. Like super warm. I cannot do it anymore. It's too warm. And, yes, I have small ribbons like so. Oh. I think when I braided my hair, I made these to put them at the bottom. Yeah. Well, don't you usually put your stuff in boxes? They packed it for me this time since it was so sudden. And it had to get done quick. So, it's kind of why, things were a bit scrambled. I also just don't have furniture. So, there's a lot of stuff in my room. And nowhere to put it! Huh. Who would've thunk? Braid hair stream. Okay! oh, I can't trust people to touch my stuff. I know, it makes me, like, really nervous, but I think, like, oftentimes accepting help is, it'll change the game a little if you need it. Oh, ouch. Tina, pick one. French toast, pancakes, or waffles? Ooh, I love French toast. Phoenix, Hannah, thanks for the 8 months. Thank you. I've played Roblox, just not on stream. I think I played Doors. But I always died. Carpet or tile? Tile, man. What in the world? Oh, Cropsington. Ah!
Mori Online donated $10. Hi, Tina. Can I
Hello?
Have some relationship advice? If not, ignore this, but basically my BF is super busy and he won't answer me, but his snap score goes up. Any thoughts on what I should do? Illy Tai.
Oh. Interesting. So your BF. Interesting. Wait, I don't know if anyone heard that, so I'll read it out loud. Hi, Tina. Can I have some relationship advice? If not, ignore this, but basically my BF is super busy and he won't answer me, but his snap score goes up. Any thoughts on what I should do? I love you, TY. I feel like, people tend to have energy for different things in their lives, you know? And in this situation, it's kind of weird if he's not, like, it's okay to want to do a little something else, but I think it's weird for him to, like, not communicate that to you and instead tell you that he's busy when he's, like, you know, not. Like, he should just, I don't know how to explain. She's cheating. Oh, you know what? Maybe I just don't really understand, like snap scores that well. But if it's, like, really going up, then, like, maybe, you know, he's cheating and, like, dumb him or whatever. But I don't know. Honestly, like, if he's not communicating it to you and it feels like he's hiding something, then, like, I don't know. I would, like, maybe jokingly, personally, maybe I would jokingly bring up the whole thing and be like, oh, that's, like, weird. Like, you kind of, I don't know, maybe I'm toxic. Tell him to pack his things. You know what? Just listen to Corpse instead. Maybe he's smarter than me, so. But, yeah. I don't know. I just, it's like everybody, like, sometimes has, like, oh my god. I don't know. Sometimes you don't have, you have time for, like, one person and not the other, you know? But if he always has time for that one person on Snapchat and he's not, like, talking about it and, you know, there might be a root problem. Like, what if he doesn't enjoy spending time with you even when he is busy, you know? Like, it's kind of, I don't know. He's gotta talk about it a little. Otherwise, you're just gonna be sad. Single just in time for summer, bestie. Live your best life. Yeah, I would definitely talk to him about it first. And if he reacts to it weird, then that's, like, the biggest red flag ever. Oh, God. Why is there a lump here? Oh, God. Time for a person. I mean, I feel this way personally, but, like, I'm like a 49, 51 intro extrovert, you know? So, like, for me, that just feels, like, sometimes, like, I need a break from people in general. And, like, sometimes it takes less. Well, maybe, I don't know, sometimes if you talk to someone, you're, like, scared you'll initiate into a full-length conversation with them or whatever. And maybe he thinks, like, you know, snapping just takes less energy, but I don't know, it's kind of weird, especially if he likes, I don't know, you know? Oh, God. What's your MBT? I think it's INFP, ENFP. They change. Oh, God. a little circle at the bottom. I'm just joking. There. Oh god, I'm going back and forth. Well, yeah, I don't know what to say. I'm not really the expert on that kind of thing, but I don't know. Ooh, we got an ambivert. I really am. Oh god. What's your attachment style? I don't know what that means. Snap score goes up just from receiving snaps too. That could also be the case. Chatter smart. Polter, thanks for the 11 months. Thank you. Okay. Tina, what is your favorite Spanish food? I can't pick favorite foods. I'm bad at that. I can't even pick my favorite, like, food in general. Like, I have a default answer, but it's not really accurate. You know? Like, when people ask me what my favorite movie is, I say Casper 1995, even though that is not my favorite movie, but I'll say it, you know, to soothe their urge. Is it weird that my BF has a hidden phone he uses to watch The Naughty? Yes! Listen, I might be one of those people that have really, like, maybe my opinion on this is a bit too much for some people, but I personally believe that shit like that rots your brain, especially young people. And I think, like, the industry in general often, like, dehumanizes women, and I don't know, it's already, like, just such a, I don't know, it's a shit industry, you know what I mean? Like, it's harmful, and, like, I don't know, I think there's a really big problem when you have a lot of, like, people that just, it teaches, I think, this is my opinion, it teaches boys from a young age that sex is something you do to a person instead of with a person, just because of the way so many women are portrayed in the media. And so I just don't really, just not a fan of it. Like, I just don't agree with it. Bigger red flag, ranked league or CSGO player? But listen, that's just my opinion. I don't know. I haven't done enough research to, like, defend my opinion, but I don't agree with that. Oh god, I think it's easy for guys who grew up watching it to say, like, oh, I turned out just fine, but I would argue sometimes otherwise based on their takes. Oh my god, I'm so sweaty. Oh, Mysterious, thanks for the raid. Can you speak Spanish for 2 minutes? I don't even know if I know 2 minutes of straight Spanish. But listen, again, I think, like, it's just a, your opinion doesn't need research. If you don't like it, that's okay. It's totally okay to have that opinion. I think, like, having the song, I think, like, when you have something like for a lot of people it's wild, you know, like, to say something like that, but it so it helps to have some research, you know, at least when you're trying to, like, get people to understand where you're coming from. Not just research, but, like, I don't know, I think having, like, at least some points to, like, you know, really go hard in the paint with it all is nice. How's the roomies been? I love it so much. I love going grocery shopping, and Miyoung loves to grocery shop with me. She's the best. Can't you turn your aircon on? I don't know how. I'd never asked. So I'm worried. Um, Let's see. Darling Willow, thanks for the 21 months. Thank you. Running errands. Yeah, we run so many errands together and it's just really fun. So yeah, I like it. Have you ever lived away from home before? Often. I live away from home a lot. I feel like those braids are very side heavy. Yeah, I don't know how to do braids on the back of my head. Maybe I'll make them like, hold on. So, what did I, okay. Ugh, this one's so thick. Oh, I guess that one. Why is this one so much bigger? Okay, wait, let me do it again. Let's see. Braiding hair is hard. No, I think so too. There are a lot of better companies though that make really intimate adult contents. I mean, that's like a whole different conversation for me personally. I think it's like, it's kind of difficult, right? Because like, you could, I'm not super comfortable like deep diving into this like on stream, but I don't know. I just worry sometimes for the gals. You know what I mean? That's all. There's a lot of little things about it. You know what I mean? Like, and it's a bit too big for me to. I'm not like the professor. It is a rabbit hole of a conversation. It goes crazy. How do you maintain your hair? I'm so bad. I wash it every day. Let's see. Emilio Enrique, thanks for the 2 years. Thank you. Have you watched The Outlast yet? No, I haven't. I'm watching Breaking Bad right now. I think I'm on season 4. Yeah. Oh god. Let's see. Crank the Mitski. Okay, I'll try. Let's see. Yay! What emote is that? There's like a sunset. What is that? What is that? What is it? Peace? Is that it says life? Oh, it's life. Oh, what, life advice has helped you? I think the biggest life advice that's ever helped me ever was when I was really young and I watched a video. It's a video accessible to like literally anybody, but it's called like, I think it's called Nihilistic Optimism. And when I was younger, I used to be really, really sad all the time about how nothing I ever did in my life mattered, because like, if I was gone tomorrow, I was just a speck of dust in the universe. So what's the point? Like that kind of thing. But then, you know, after watching that video, I thought a lot about how, because I'm such a speck of dust in the universe and that nothing, I guess, technically matters, my life purpose could be literally anything I wanted it to be. And it didn't have to be what anybody considered to be a good life. You know, like, you don't have to be the best at something. Like, if there's like little things that you enjoy in life, like maybe like the smell of coffee or the way certain flowers smell when you walk by, or like that tingle of warmth you get when you walk outside and the sun hits you, like that can be your life purpose, you know, just enjoying like little things like that. Like, it, to me, changed the way I felt a lot about feeling so small and so unimportant. You know what I mean? Like, literally, like, just existing. And finding like pleasure in like even the littlest of things. Yeah, exactly. It doesn't matter to it doesn't matter. You know, like I don't know, it's just so I think like not caring but in a good way. Tia, thanks for the prime carrots for Crunch. Thanks for gifting us up to Valkyrie Crunch. Like, I don't know. Washing the rice. Yeah, washing rice does matter. But it's because it kind of removes a lot of the starch. So, I don't know. Not caring for the sake of your happiness. Yeah, exactly. Oh. Aveshy, thanks to the 10 months. Fetal, thanks to the 3 months. Thank you. Yeah. Do you like to cook? A little bit, but only sometimes. Your bangs are great. I know, they're finally like... it's. I think the one that I cut is this long now. So that's not so bad. Oh, God. Do you have a least favorite food? Celery, probably. I think. Oh, heavens. The micro bangs are leaving. Yeah, a little bit. Oh, God. Della Rosie, thanks for the 3 months. Thank you. What celery is bomb? It's stringy and it tastes weird. It tastes flowery, kind of. I don't know. I'm not, like, the biggest fan. Do you have a favorite Disney princess? I really like... Tiana? I think is like one of my favorite Disney princesses. I think the later Disney princess movies are always just a little bit better because they give them so much more personality. Like, and I don't know, I really liked Donna. Like, she worked really hard and I don't know, she was just, I don't know, I liked her personality a lot. And she was so beautiful. Rapunzel. Yeah, I remember really liking Rapunzel as well. She's cool. What's your favorite football team? I don't know, man. Maybe like the Bengals. I don't know. Something about Disney 2D animation is so special to me. I wish they did it more. But of course, animation always gets the short end of the stick. Joe Shiesty, number 9. I'm a super anxious person. What tips do you have to help? Dude, I wish I could tell you how to not be anxious, but I can't. I'm so sorry. How do you like your bagels? Toasted with cream cheese. I like an everything bagel that's toasted with cream cheese or ran through the garden. Like maybe with, is it lox? And those little like cornichons and then the capers. Yeah. Are you still watching One Piece? I took a tiny break. A tiny One Piece break. Hope you don't mind me asking, what's your skincare routine? You don't want it. Because it's, I don't really know what I'm doing. And also, I break out a lot through, like, through hormonal acne. Have you watched Oshinoko yet? I have watched the first episode. And I will say, my patience for anime thins constantly. Oh, the twist is bothering you. Let me fix it. Oh my God, why is it like that? I watched it yesterday, that's why. But I listen, I just my patience for anime thins all the time. Like they do not have to be 16 years old. I'm sorry. I've had enough. Like why do we insist on having these adult ass conversations and topics and make them 16 or 14? It's ridiculous. Rich Fruit, these are the five gifted. Like I've had enough, especially if somebody is like somebody needs to be attracted to them. It is fucking weird. Like stop. They do not have to be 16. Like, oh my God, I hate it so much. I hate it. Kids save the world, but oh, they can be kids saving the world, but at the same time, they do not have to be like a point of attraction for adults. Like that is weird to me. And I remember when I was in high school, I didn't understand how it was weird because I was like, oh, that's literally me. Like who cares? But now that I am like an adult and I know that grown ass people are making these shows, it makes me a little uncomfortable. Like, I'm like, why? I don't know. I can't. Let's see. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, kids can save the world without adults sexualizing them. No, exactly. I feel like in Ghibli, it's a like, it basically happens a lot. Like there's a lot of like young girl protagonists that are not sexualized. I'm like, thank fucking God. Thank you. They are old inside, though. What do you mean? What does that mean? What are you talking about? You are wrong. That's copium. That's weird. Yabika, thanks for the 4 months. Listen, it's just, I can't. Red alert, red alert. Yeah, they could be talking. They mean in Oshinoko, the kids have adult minds. One of them was literally like 12. You know? One of them was 12. And the other one was a whole ass doctor that liked a 16-year-old and 12-year-old. That is weird. That is very strange and bad. Slurp, thank you for the 5 months. Like literally as the episode goes, I'm like, I was like, oh. Like this entire time, like it just makes everything such a hard watch. And I would just like it to stop. What can I do about it? I don't know. Nothing, I guess. But that's very annoying. What's your fave Studio Ghibli film? I mean, I really like Howl's Moving Castle. If it is a fantasy world, I don't see the issue. I don't agree with that because you shouldn't be fantasizing about where you could date younger people. Like, you know what I mean? Like, that is, it doesn't matter if it's a fantasy world. That should not be your fantasy. You know what I mean? That you are enjoying. You know what I mean? Like, that is weird. Yeah. People are self-reporting, like straight up. Let's see. God. Listen, I'm not the professional, not the expert, but I can't admit it's not fucking weird. What's your favorite movie? Dude, I couldn't. Casper, 1995. A puppy cat. Yeah. Dude, every time someone types a Y in all cats, it's literally just puppy cat doing this. And I'm like, that is just such a normal word for, like, with Christina Ricci. Is it, dude, is it Ricci or Ricky? Because, like, I feel like that word to me is, like, I don't know. Oh, God. You wish you had your hair? You want to shave your curls? Absolutely not. Curly hair is so beautiful. It is gorgeous. I always look at, like, Ray's, like, curly hair or Pokey's hair, and I'm like, wow. It is just so nice. Like, it's beautiful. I love it so much. Like, I get that the grass is always greener. But just know that there's people with straight hair that look at your hair and think it's so pretty. I will say that, like, maintenance might be a lot easier, though, when your hair is straight. Let's see. Crops. Tina, do you like Shrek? Shrek 2 is so good. No, I agree. I think, like, Shrek 2 is a sequel that outshines the first movie. It's really good. I remember when I was on curly hair TikTok for a while, and it was a lot of people, like, dipping their hair in the bowls. The bowl method. Scrunching. I was like, oh, okay. I was like, I don't know why I'm watching this. I'm not gonna use this, but maybe one day I need to wash someone's hair. Jess, thanks for the 13 months. Tokola, thanks for the 6 months. Shrek 2 is, I think it is actually discussed enough. A lot of people like that movie. I will say, like, I've purchased very few movies, and Shrek 2 was one of them. Didn't even buy the first one. Let's see. I miss your ASMR era. I've never had an ASMR era. Have I? Hello. Hola. Hold on. Let me turn this up. Start it right now. Okay, got it. Let me bring out my notepad. Let's see, Crunchcraft. Oh, that kind of ASMR. I see. Nid, thanks for the 16 months. That means I have to wake up super early. I would do Crunchcraft more, but sometimes I feel nervous that people wouldn't really want Crunchcraft. It feels kind of niche now. It's not dead. Oh god, the pink sheep. Aww, you guys are so cute, what the heck? So cute! It started with just you, we'll enjoy if we- Stop, I'll cry, I have teary eyes! That's so nice, it did start with just me, didn't it? It is just- it was just supposed to be like my whole little thing. Richie, thanks for the 5 gifted, thank you Richie, thank you! Did you finish the roof? I don't know. I don't think I did. Oh, hi, Carl. Hi there. Anon, thanks for gifting a tier 2 sub. What the heck? Thank you. Morning Minecraft at 10 p.m. Oh, probably not. Oh my God, that cat emo. What the heck? It's like panting like a dog. It probably needs water. Oh. Does your floor ever get cold? Oh my God, it is so cold. I like wanna wear socks just so that I don't have to like deal with it. I wish this hair was trained to go on the side a little more. Oh God, it's all messy now. I'm gonna stop showering at night. I feel like it makes my ha hair so hard to manage at nighttime now. Do you read Webtoon? I'm gonna be so honest with you guys. I do not read, and I wish I did. I should read a lot more. Okay. Let's see. I feel like a lot of you guys are readers too. You know, consumers of literature, and I am just not. Annie Valor, thanks for the 16 months. Cindy, thanks for the tier one. Yeah. Oh, offline chat. Plink plink. What? Why are you? Okay. I love to read. Yeah, I can tell you guys are little smarties. So cute. Hair turns crazy sometimes. I know. I don't know what to do about it. I'm reading right now as I listen to the stream. How are you doing that? I feel like that is very difficult to do. Guys, Myung made me a steak dinner last night, just saying. I didn't even have to order food. Benjen, thanks for the 3 months. Yeah, she made me a whole steak dinner with little pine mushrooms, asparagus, some rice. She's a little sweetie, and she like marinated the steak too. Not you flexing. I want a Myung too. Yeah, and she also drives me. And like literally today, she made me a chicken quesadilla, and there was cheese in it, and also mushrooms. And that she made me that 2 days in a row. Yeah, and she cleaned up afterwards. She did the dishes, which is crazy. And today I put away some of the dishes, save for two bowls, because I didn't know where they would go. And one of them was a special bowl, a handmade ceramic bowl, so I didn't know where it was supposed to go because it didn't look like the rest of the bowls, and I knew it was a bowl that she really liked, so I was like, where do I put this bowl? So I just put it there. I just left it. But then I organized the pantry a little bit, and I'm really proud of myself because it was like, you know, real life Tetris, and I was like, wow, this is so exciting that I get to organize food like this. It was fun. I liked it. Yeah, it was. I was like, I can organize this so much better. I can place these blocks the way I want to. And yeah. Yo también what? What are you talking about? You said yo también to people talk bowl. How is that a Me Too moment? People talk bowl, and then you said yo también. Interesting. Tú eres bonito como una gatita. Sí. Sí. I'm confused. I don't know. I'm confused as well. My bad. I wish you guys could see my iPad. No te preocupes. Preocupes. Yeah, you're an iPad kid. Maybe.
Maybe.
Do you play Duolingo? No, I don't. Real Tina. Hi, Silvita. You should play Tetris and stream again. Oh, yeah, I could. But then I get kind of quiet when I play Tetris. And then it makes you feel a little bit bad. You know what I mean? Because I'm not... I'm a little bit chalked. So, I don't know. Lunes, martes, miércoles, jueves, viernes, sábado. Oh, sábado, 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 sábado. That word is so hard because of the accent for me, I feel like. Domingo. Cuídate. 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 Oh God. A Tina Gatita le gusta la sopita. Sí. Oh. Cuídate. 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 Kumi, the word's hard. This is such a Tetris-coded song. Cui? Cuidate? Cuidate instead of, oh, because I'm saying like cuidate instead of cuidate. No? I don't know. It's okay, the two ways both are good. I notice whenever there's a that like a word with date in it, I feel like I always say it longer. You struggle with third syllable accent marks? I do! How did you know? Or accent marks in general. Quédate. Quédate, por favor. Quédate. Maritza is bored. Thanks for the tier one. Thank you. Thank you. We say cuidate in Argentina. Oh my God. Argentina. Two is correct. But wouldn't it be weird if I tried so many different... If I was speaking with like multiple accents in one sentence... It's your country. It's true. Oh my God, Mila. Is it ultimamente? Ultimamente? What does that mean? What is that, Kumi? Lately? Ultimamente? Why do I think you'd like living in New York? Because I would. Because I would, crunchy vibes. I would. You know what? Aww. Dude, honestly... Okay, wait. Can I be so real? Sometimes when I, like, see your guys's, like... Oh my God. I see your, like, little chat messages. And then I just see, like... Oh, maybe this is, like, creepy. But I see, like, the history of your chat messages. And it's just all so wholesome. And then I get teary-eyed. And I'm like, wow, so cute. What a cute human. And then sometimes you have little profile pictures. And I'm like, it's so cute. I get so teary-eyed. Oh, my. It's so cute. Oh, I get... Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Why am I getting emotional? Because. Oh. Oh my goodness. Cute. Ugh. Oh my goodness. Ugh. I love your content so much. Please don't let any humans haters put you down. Dude, I don't think about it unless people talk about it, I guess. Oh my goodness. My only thing, dude, I will say though, I get drunk. I'm not drunk. This is an energy drink. This is actually, oh my god. This is Juvie, which is Matt Nade Shot's drink. Foolish. Foolish. Foolish gamers. Hola, Tontinto Tiburon. Well, this is, yeah, it's just Juvie, but it's like before they put the logo on the tin, so it's like, you know, like a little cute. I was drinking this a lot back in the day. Yeah, this is really awkward. I was like literally tearing up because I got emotional over the smallest thing. Oh, foolish. Thank you for the raid. Muchas gracias por el raid, Tontito Tiburón. Muchas gracias. Yeah, I was getting emotional because I thought a chatter was just being so precious, so. And then when I clicked their profile, I was like, oh, that's a whole ass human. And they said all these nice things, and I was just like, so cute. You know? Sometimes I just, when I read chat, I'm like, oh my god, it's a bunch of like little like cats because of the, you know. Because of the little emotes sometimes. Oh, it's... Oh, Jesus. Not the bang. I wasn't really doing anything at the moment, guys. I was just hanging out and chatting a little bit and stuff. Because, you know, today I must be somewhere. What can I say? Your hair looks cute today. I braided it on stream while I was talking to chat. Today we're just hanging out a little bit. I can't believe I talked for like an hour straight. We love chatting. Yes, we do sometimes, don't we? Who's your favorite egg from QSMP? I feel like I can't pick favorites, but I do know of Leo the most. Just because I've seen Leo the most. Leo's so good at building. It's very impressive. Our favorite Nepo child. It's because her fathers are good at building. Tina can't read. Says who? I can read. Huh? What is happening? How did you come to that conclusion? I'm getting one guide again. Oh my god. Literally nobody has like said anything like that, and I just read the one message out of like everything. I need to stop, dude. I need to stop. I can read, I just don't sometimes. I get very distracted. Tina looks like she doesn't know how to ride a bike. Actually, I'll have you know that I can ride a bike. And I can ride a motorbike too. But I can't drive cars. Hassan coded now. Listen. Yeah, I can ride a motorbike. But I can't drive cars. Because I don't know how. There's a very good explanation for this. Okay? Basically, when you're in a car, you're not in the center. And there's a lot of extra space that you have to be very spatially aware of on your sides that I can't do when I'm in a car. But when you're in a motorbike, it's not like the vehicle goes past your arm even. It's like right here, you know? So it's really easy to like see if you're gonna hit something or not. So that's why I think I'm okay with driving and stuff. Driving motorbikes. Get a Mini Cooper. I also just don't know if I want like a really small car in the US because everybody's cars are so big. F-150s or whatever, everywhere. The cars are massive, and I feel like if they hit me, I'll die. You know? Get a G-Wagon. I don't think I can. I'm not. I've rode in a G-Wagon before. It's kind of nice, actually. Because when people do like that, the seat actually grabs you. Like, it's kind of weird. It catches you a little bit. Like, the seats like move and they like hold on to you. I'm like, oh. I was like, I remember like being like so scared. When I was like in the passenger seat, of course, and then someone went and I was like, yay! And then like it like grabbed my side so that I didn't like move a lot in place. It was actually kind of cool. I was like, oh my God, thank you, so cool. Yeah, it was awesome. I can see you driving those cars with the flower wheels. So my dream is a Volkswagen convertible Beetle with daisy rims. Maybe like a pastel yellow or pastel pink. I think maybe pastel yellow would be good. Maybe periwinkle. Yeah, periwinkle would be good. But I don't know. I thought I want that kind of car so bad. I think it would be so cute. I love daisy wheels. I love the bugs. I like the vintage style bugs too. I wish they made them look like that, like more often, but less like gas guzzly. You know what I mean? Like, I want my car to feel eco-friendly, like electric. Oh my God, if they remade the vintage bug and made it electric, mwah, name a more perfect automobile. There could be none. That would be my car. Yeah. Anyways, Volkswagen, hit me up or whatever. Oh my God, imagine the first time I ever collab and I make a product, it's a car. That'd be awesome. Never before seen. Electric cars aren't that eco-friendly because of the battery. There's definitely pros and cons, I'm aware. But I will say, I think there's a world where you can innovate the battery, right? It's not like the current state of the battery is all we'll ever have. You know what I mean? Yeah, first merch is a whole ass car. There'd be like one purchase max, and it would be me. I think like I don't know. I do think like the battery is probably like, not that eco-friendly, but listen, I still think it's better, especially if, we find a way to do something with it. I think it's much better. I'd have to support you from afar. You know what? That's okay. Oh. I'll send maybe at the same time we'll release bumper stickers. Yeah. People fixate on the battery. It's still better than the alternative. Yeah, they'd like us to fixate on the battery, wouldn't they? Tesla has extremely unsafe and dangerous factory conditions. Well, I mean, that's why they have to make cars, electric vehicles other than Tesla ones, you know what I mean? They shouldn't be the only ones releasing electric vehicles, in my opinion. Like, you know, just consuming anything in general is always not the most eco-friendly. You know what I mean? Like, being alive is very expensive in terms of, like, earthly costs. The best thing you can do is try to make something that minimizes your harm on the earth altogether. There's no ethical consumption under capitalism or whatever they say. Yeah, you know, you just gotta do the absolute best that you can. You know what I mean? So, you know, just do your best. And that's all you can really ask of someone, in my opinion. Try your darndest. Exactly. Try your darndest. Everything has pros and cons, and it takes years for us to find viable solutions as a conservation major. I feel like that's something that, like, I kind of wanted to go into, too, if I actually pursued, like, schooling and stuff. I think about going into school a lot, but for stuff like that, I feel like I kind of have a bit of a tree hugger spirit, but I'm not educated enough. But I kind of, like, I don't know, you know? Yeah, always worth a shot. You could do online school. I want to go to school with someone, though. I don't want to go to school alone in this space. I'm a streamer. Study stream. Dude, there's some, like, TikTok lives where people ask Michael. Like, Michael Reeves? Does he go to school? I thought you were an art major. Oh, no, I never went to, like, school for art. I went to, like, whatchamacallit? Oh, geez. It was, like, a Hagwon, which is, like, an after-school study kind of club thing. So, yeah. It was something like that, and I did it for, like, 3 months. Oh, God. Oh, God. She's a Tetris major. Did you get to see any shooting stars earlier tonight? No, I've been inside. Streaming. Damn. You mean to tell me there were shooting stars and we're all on Twitch.tv? Oh, God. Bro. I just feel like I would never know this until after the fact. I'll go to school with you. Aw, Silvita. Who's to say I'm not camping? Camping? Oh, who gave the stars guns? Alright. Yeah, that tickled me. Jonalinus, thanks for the 5 gifted. What the heck? Thank you. Oh my God. What a good guy you are, Jonalinus. Classic Jonalinus behavior. You wanna, Tina, don't worry. You wouldn't be able to see it in LA with all the pollution. Yeah. Cat person, thanks for the 31 months. Yeah, that's a disparage for real. Oh, God. Disparage. Dude, something's gotta give. This bang is the worst. Okay, I'm gonna have to start curling it, I think. That way, it won't just go straight down. I'm almost done my 4 years of university, and Loki said it's fun. I think some people do so well in the school environment. But me, I crumble. I crumble. I crack so bad in an academic setting. Deadlines that are really strict. Guys, I'm so bad at shit like that. Kai, thanks to the tier one, I feel like I would fail. It can be very discouraging, right? I know. My brain is, oh my, next. It was itching my brain in a weird way. All right, let's see. Okay. What would you want to do if you were a streamer? Dude, I didn't really think about it that much. I think I wanted to be a barista. And live life day by day, you know? Because, I definitely did not have money to... I didn't have the high school, like, you know... I didn't do well in high school. And I didn't have enough, like, academic support, you could say. Not academic, financial support. So there's just... I did not think I could attend school in good conscience unless I knew exactly what I wanted to do. So I was like, okay, I think I'm just going to go to... I'm gonna make coffee for a little and then I'll think about it. Because I think at the time I was like, in order to not mentally crumble, I will just think about what I can do tomorrow instead of 5 years from now, because it was scaring me. Yeah. Yeah, honestly, a financially sound choice. Yeah, I really can't wait for the Harlequin Spotify thing season 2. Oh my gosh, I'm glad you liked it. It was good. I'm learning to make coffee, and that's actually harder than I thought. Dude, there's so many, like, different things when it comes to, like, making coffee. It actually gets so complex, but, you know. Yeah, and they love to ask you the five-year question in interviews, and I'm just like, bro, I don't know exactly. Especially, like, with, like, entry-level jobs, I'm like, why do you want to know where I'll be 5 years from now? I'm not here, like, you know what I mean? Hopefully not. I don't know. Cold brew is easy. Yeah, imagine if you're, like, honest in those interviews. It's ridiculous. Ray used to call espresso espresso. I'm ashamed. Honestly, that's, like, that's valid. Like, I feel like it's very express. It looks like it's express, okay? It comes out in, like, 30 seconds or something. It's pretty. It gets you fast. It's express. It makes you feel express. Espresso. I'm on your side. Don't be ashamed. It's their fault. Let's see. Yeah. Oh, why did I think you're saying is valid for me to be ashamed? No. Let's see. You're trying on your prom dress. Oh my god, good luck. Dude, I always, like, struggled with, oh my god, like, just dressing up in general, I always struggle with it because, yeah, I don't know. I'm so bad at dressing up. Like, stream rewards, it's a nightmare for dressing up for stuff like that. I struggle a lot. I was very uncomfortable wearing dresses and stuff. But it's just because I feel like when you wear... I guess I could have worn a suit, but I also... I feel like I don't typically dress very masculine, but I also struggle showing my, like, shoulders and stuff, you know? So, like, when dresses are, like, the option or it's, like, a suit... I feel like I struggle there, like, a lot. You know what I mean? I know there's like, I'm just not like a big suit person personally. For me, I think I love suits on other people. I think it looks so good on them. But for my frame, I struggle with them sometimes. I don't know. Your flower girl fit for Wendy's was good. Well, it's because I knew that I could dress as like something more costumey because it was like a flower girl kind of vibe versus like a dress where everyone's supposed to be formal and flashy. Like, even my dress wasn't that, like, it felt slightly informal because of the material. Like, I feel like it was supposed to be like sequins and stuff like that, but I picked it because I was like, maybe I can wear this again in another day, especially because it was a little bit expensive. I was like, ouch. So for something like that, I was like, I want it to be rewearable personally. Yeah. Ouch indeed. Yeah, it wasn't fun buying stuff. Yeah. Renting is better. I would have loved to rent an outfit, and I looked at a lot of like rental places, and a lot of the things that I tried just did not fit me well. So I had to end up buying, especially because it was like time was like ticking down. You always need more time than you think you do. But I love, like, I wanted to rent really bad because I don't like having, like, dresses. I hate how oftentimes we always have to get these dresses that we can only technically wear for one night often. You know, like, for prom, you can't just wear the same prom dress every year. You could. But people don't typically do that, and sometimes people expect you to wear something different. And I can't just wear the same dress every time because people are going to be like, didn't you wear that last time? And I'm going to be like, yes, I did. But dresses are expensive. You know? Oh, God. I didn't keep track, but like, I know that a lot of people in our brains kind of feel that way. You know what I mean? Like I don't check on anybody when it comes to stuff like that, especially because I feel that way. There's no way that I'm doing stuff like that if I feel, you know, like, I don't know. Yeah, you can always sell the dress and get a new one. Who is buying my dress? You know what I mean? Who would buy it? It's also a bit much. I think I will just wear it again, but for something else, and maybe dress it up in a different way. I'll try. I will buy, smiley. Let's see. Wear it to breakfast. My floor. Well, it's not floor length, is it? Schools do this thing where you can trade dresses with people for free. Honestly, that's kind of cute. Yeah. You know what? Yeah. Honestly, we're at grocery shopping. That's kind of a mood. I agree with that, actually. I like when people wear, like, extravagant things in the grocery store. It's kind of the best. People make their own stuff. Yeah, it's super cute. Let's see. I do think it's harder for younger people to get a nice dress. Like, unless you have a family that'll back you up and, like spend a lot of money on, like, your dresses, it's not, like, ideal, right? I never felt, like, super comfortable asking for too much for my dress. Because, you know, it's just rude to, I feel like. But, I don't know, some people definitely go all out.
Uh,
Yeah, it definitely made me feel guilty for sure. Did you ever try to make a dress? I don't know how to sew. I think it would be cool if I learned how to, but alas, no housekeeping skills. What kinds of men's style do you find attractive? Like men's styles? I like it when men's fashion is typically like I like it when people dress up and you can tell that they're very confident in their sexuality. You know what I mean? I don't like it like they're not like afraid of like having like pretty clothing, you know? 'Cause when it's just too yeah. I don't know. I kind of like stuff like that. I think it looks good. 'Cause it like I don't know. Yeah, the confidence and like I don't know, like not being afraid of like a shorter inseam 'cause or like or even like maybe like crop tops, like if they're confident enough, like just like being like comfortable, I feel like is nice. Yeah. I think like the toxic masculine style, I'm like yeah, confidence can make or break an outfit. It's true. Cropped up for men. Yeah, you'd be surprised. I mean, like there I think there was like this picture of it might have been Will Smith. I'm pretty sure he wore a crop top in I don't remember what the show is called. Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. Was he wearing a crop top in that one? I was like, oh, that actually looks like really nice, especially if he like owns it, you know? And like I think like having like that kind of confidence and stuff like that is cool and it always looks good. And I think a lot of men's fashion is super I don't know. It's a bit more or less the same all the time, unless you get a little more confident with it, you know? Yeah. Yeah, stale. That's the word I'm looking for, I guess. I've seen crop tops in the NFL. Oh, I wouldn't know. I haven't seen it. Drum, thanks for the 8 months. Shorter inseams are a nightmare for me. I'm most comfortable in the baggiest of clothes where I mean, yeah, I wear a lot of like baggy clothes too sometimes. At least on top, I feel like I wear a lot of baggy clothes. But you know, I don't know, you'd be surprised. A lot of athletes have started wearing crop clothes lately. Yeah. Baggy is in right now. Yeah, I think like baggy sweatpants and stuff is pretty, or like I know cargo shorts are pretty in. And they're comfortable too. Yeah. In the 70s and 80s, men's crop tops were way more popular, and I hate that it's considered too feminine. Yeah, I don't know. Like I think I don't know, there's an interesting like I don't know if this actually applied to the crop tops thing going on, but there's like this thing that happens sometimes where like typically like men will do something and as soon as like women or young women like get into it, it's then considered like a women thing and then all of a sudden as a guy, you're not supposed to touch that because, God, the worst thing that could happen is being associated with anything feminine. And that's why I think it's cool when people don't give a fuck about it. Like it happened with the Beatles. It happened with Heels. Yes, exactly. I remember that too. So, you know, I guess when it comes to like being attracted to anything, I think it's nice when guys like express any sort of femininity without making a mockery of it, you know? Like, there's such a big difference. Tina prefers if guys are based. Yeah, I guess so. What about in women's clothing? I don't know. I don't really think about it too much. Because I feel like girls just kind of wear whatever. Right? Let's see. I feel like women's fashion is a lot more... It's not as... It's not as stale because no matter what we do, we get shit on. So we just wear whatever. You know? Let's see. Baggy pants, tight top. Yeah, I like that look. It's cute. What type of person were you in high school? Probably just a cringy teen, I guess. I don't know. I feel like all teenagers are a little awkward. I don't know, though. I feel like TikTok is kind of... TikTok and the internet... Not just TikTok, obviously. But, like, the internet was, like, not as cool now. Like, it's just a lot better now than it was back then. You know? I don't know. The internet just gets... I know you, like, some people would disagree, but it was just... It was so much worse back then. Like, and it wasn't as informative and, like... I don't know. Now there's, like, a lot of really cool art resources. A lot more recipes online. A lot more makeup tutorials. Like, my eyebrows, I didn't even do them back then. And they were just sparse, and I wasn't really allowed to wear much makeup. I don't know. Like, I feel like, people are learning how to express themselves a lot faster. Whether that's good or bad, or whether they're not, you know. I don't know. Thin eyebrows were the in thing back then. Well, I actually just... Actually, back when I was younger, really thick eyebrows were kind of in. I think especially because of Cara Delevingne, maybe. I think, like, her eyebrows really made a lot of people want big, thick eyebrows. But I didn't know how to do them because if you've never done your eyebrows before, filling your eyebrows in... is like really weird. Like, I remember, like, when I looked at my face when I filled in my eyebrows for the first time, I was like, oh my god, I look so bizarre because I had like no eyebrows whatsoever. And I was like, and now I can't not fill in my eyebrows. But basically, if you would just imagine like no eyebrows, that's what I look like. I'm 25. Oh, well, I'm 24. I'm turning 25. I'm already saying I'm 25. When I should just really, like, juice up these last months. But, I can't, I don't know. I just feel like I'm 25. Oh, hello. Thank you for the 8 months. Thank you. It depends on the face. It doesn't match all faces. I mean, I think... I don't know. I've been doing my eyebrows even lighter lately. Enjoy your age. I mean, I am enjoying my age. I think, like, I've gotten a lot... I like myself so much more now than when I was 18, 19, 20. I just know a lot more. And I'm like a lot more protective of my brain. And I'm a lot less tolerant of like bad things. I don't like, I don't know. I stand up for myself and other people more. So I like me at 24 way more than 18, 19, 20, 21. So it's not so bad. You know what I mean? You have nothing to worry about being like, I don't know, getting older. People think you crumble to dust as soon as you hit 20. When I turned 20, I cried. I cried and I cried and I cried because I was like, oh yeah, don't share your age in chat. But when I turned 20, when I turned 18, I felt so like the internet made me feel, just society in general, especially as a girl, makes you feel so undesirable the older you get. Even at 20. Like, I know for a fact it's different for guys, but for, you know, a woman especially, they make you feel so undesirable. Like, your life is going to crumble as soon as you hit 21 or something. And, like, your old news, like, you know, it's just, it's so wrong. You know what I mean? And, like, this whole being obsessed with, like, people super young is just so bad because everybody gets older. And aging is a privilege. You know what I mean? Guys get to be silver foxes, Sag. I know, but I think, like, it'll take work, but we can shift the narrative, too. It just will take a little while. Culture stuff, I don't know. It takes a while to change it all. So, I don't know. I am really proud of how far I've come at my age. And even if I was older, I would still be proud. You should just aim to be like better than you were yesterday. But it's not always like super linear, you know? Like if you take a little dip, you'll just learn a lot more and then you'll get... Just learn every day. Pandemic robbed us all. Yeah, there's definitely like a lot of people might feel a little bit, especially socially behind because of the pandemic, but it's you and everybody else. You know what I mean? So everyone's a little bit more awkward right now, but it's okay. We'll get over it. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, we all went there together. Progression is not linear. Yeah, it's definitely not. Because, I don't know, especially like when shit hits the fan, it feels like you just went straight back to square one. But I don't know, like you kind of have to know what's wrong to fix things, you know what I mean? Yeah, so don't be afraid of getting older. Not even a little. It's good to be wiser. And hopefully you are better to yourself the older you get. You know what I mean? my throat is like so dry from talking for hours. From 23 and every bone in my body feels like shit. When you get... I feel like I've always had knee problems. So when I talk about my knees, people are like, oh God, she's getting to that age. But I remember being like 7 and running and my knees would hurt so bad. I don't know, maybe I have like cartilage issues. But I can't wait to be 100. I feel like you probably would be 100. Probably. I don't know. Foolish would outlive many people. There's just nothing like I think like he just doesn't really get sick. And when he does, he still goes live. Could never be me. I don't go live when there's a minor inconvenience. If I'm feeling a little sad, I'm just not going live. And I learned my lesson because of this from Among Us days, where if I went live knowing I wasn't feeling okay, I knew I would cry on stream. And so I was like, no more. If something's off, I'm not going live. I can't. Because, I don't know. He does get the live itches. He does. And I understand, like, me choosing to not do stuff like that is a privilege I will never take for granted because, you know, I remember working my, God, it wasn't even a 9 to 5. It was like a 7 to 5. And I would cry so much at work. It was so bad. And I worked with children. They're like, Miss Tina, why are you crying? And I'd be like, I don't know, I'm so sorry. Or I'd be in the closet with the I'd be like, oh my God, Ro. Yeah, it was really bad. And it was just so awkward too. Like, there's just no way I should be working with kids because I'm just like so awkward with children. I'm like uncomfortable. I'm like, these are whole ass people. But they're just small. Yeah. Yeah. It's yeah, working at a preschool is hard. Especially because I know that like children are like our future, you know what I mean? It's why I don't want a kid. I'm scared of them. They are like children are everything. You know what I mean? Like they grow up to be just like us, and everything you do matters. It's so scary. And like, you know, you see this and you think about it all the time, but like when you think about like how your parents gave you trauma in some way, shape, or form, your parents were also just kids and they also had trauma and they didn't know. Sometimes the people don't know how to take care of kids and they pass down their trauma to you because they don't know any other way and nobody ever told them. And like, you know, they didn't mean it. Like, it's just kind of. So I just get scared. I'm like, oh my God, like, what if I like. Oh, it makes me upset. Yeah, girl, like I don't know, like your parents were kids too, and they did their best. It's your parents' first life too. Yeah, like they couldn't have known. I don't know. Makes me sad. Kids are so moldable. I know they're just malleable little Play-Dohs with soul in them. So, I don't know. Play some about listen. I don't know if I even have time for a game now. But honestly, we have the rest of our lives. I'll play Valorant tomorrow. Yeah, I'll play tomorrow, probably. But everyone's a child. Some are just grown-up children. No, really. And like, I don't think I could ever have a kid. I'm so scared of children. But I, you know, don't yep me. I'll do it tomorrow. Oh my God. Bro. I will. As the eldest, that was a trial run for my siblings. I mean, definitely. Yeah. Her ass is not going live tomorrow. I will go live tomorrow. I will. I will. I will. Let me check the calendar. I will. You also said you weren't moving. Okay, but like it had to be a surprise. The Valorant stream tomorrow does not have to be a surprise. I was trying to surprise you guys. That's different. Okay. I was trying to do a little surprise. Okay. And it didn't work because I. Listen, it was very difficult to hide that. I don't know. It was You were telling, yeah, I know, because it was sentimental. I was like, wow, guys, look around. That's kind of sad. Like, I wanted you guys to at least say your goodbyes, you know? I wanted you guys to say your goodbyes. But I also didn't want to tell you. It was very difficult. Okay. Maddie, thank you for the 1 year. Hi, Tina. Happy 1 year. I have a big girl adulting job now. Oh, my God. Happy for you. Congratulations. What the heck? Oh, my goodness. That is so backwards. What is backwards? I wanted you to say bye. We knew for months? No. No. The happiest. Thanks for the prime. No. Yeah, oh my god, new prime sub. Oh goodness. Hi Tina, who are you? I'm Tina. I'm a variety streamer. I hang out all the time. My name's Tina Kitson, but I don't have a cat. Sold. Yeah, oh god. Dude, you ever get those, like, prompts where it's like, write a little tidbit about yourself, and I'm like, I would rather never do that ever, ever, ever. Like, because it just, what am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to say about myself? I'm not trying to... I don't like saying anything about myself. You know? Like, tell us a little something about yourself. I'm like, no. Why don't you find out? No. I get embarrassed talking about myself to strangers. Oh my god. I'm a streamer. There's ways to do it without, like, being, like, introed in that way, though. You know what I mean? Like, I don't know, your hobbies, favorite. Yeah, I would rather do something like that. I'd be like, yeah, I don't know. Doesn't have a kitten. I wish. I think if a cat, like, peed somewhere, I don't know if I have the patience for it yet. I'm waiting until I grow up a little more. Because I think right now, if my cat peed on something, I might cry for a long time. And if they did it at maybe 3 in the morning, I would lose it. Litter box. One time I picked up this cat from the street and it peed next to the litter box, but not in it. Next to it. Every time. I changed the litter so many times. I changed the litter box so many times. And they just... I would pick it up and put it in the... And it literally did this. Like, clutching onto the sides. It was like, don't put me in there. Like, it was water. I was like, what is wrong with you? And then, like, it was so insane. And then, like, poor little cat doesn't know any better. Well, I found out that this cat was previously owned by someone. And someone, like, abandoned it. It had a chip. It wasn't feral. And so, yeah, it was ridiculous. And so it was just like, you know, it would pee next to it, though. Like, literally right next to it. And the worst thing is that the surface tension, it would, like, stick to the litter box as soon as the pool of piss would hit the litter box. And then that tension between the box and the floor. And so then it would go all under the box, which would make a... It would make it so much harder to clean than if it would just pee in an isolated spot. But that cat was so sweet. So sweet. I had to give it to a shelter. I remember. And the shelter was like, oh, we literally had this cat before. This cat used to be ours. But somebody that used to live here abandoned it. And we were like, I was like, oh. And I remember, like, sobbing. I was so sad. But I picked this cat up from the street, my sibling and I, actually. And it was the sweetest cat ever, besides that one problem. I was like, bro, how is this cat perfect? Besides this part, this one part is like, and like obviously, like it's my parents' house. Like, I'm not gonna make my parents deal with a cat that they told me not to bring home, by the way, and all now it's just peeing all over it. So, you know, I was young and it had to be done. It was orange. It was an orange cat. And it had no caloric intent, like intelligence whatsoever. Like, it would eat so much. I would feed it and it would meow at me nonstop and it would go meow, and then it would like look at me and then like walk, look back to see if I was following him, and then keep walking and looking back. And I was like, I just fed you, bro. You're a bottomless pit. Bottomless. It was so scary. I was like, oh my God, it never ends. Yeah, little Garf. I called him Garf. Cats will do that if you don't. I did enforce meal times. I did. I tried to be the best. I kept that cat for weeks. I think like 2 or 3 weeks. And so my mom was mad because cat pee is like aggressive, you know? And so I got really attached to it. And then when I had to give it up, I was like dying. I was like, oh my God, this is the worst thing ever. It was so heartbreaking. But it was perfect. Like, it was one of those cats where if you touch their stomach, they didn't care. It wouldn't scratch you. It loved tummy rubs. Cats that love tummy rubs are so rare, I like it would like, I don't know, it like I could pick him up and like he loved being like held, or I don't know, and like just being like cuddled a lot. And like every time I would go to sleep, he would like jump in my bed and purr the whole time, like just nonstop purr machine, like brr, you know, like I was like, wow. And then like I don't know, it was just so snuggly. Jamie, thank you for the sub. Yeah, it was the perfect cat, except for that part. And I'm just so scared. I'm like scared that it'll happen again. There's this girl on TikTok with the most affectionate cat ever. I'm so jealous. Like, Junie, that rag doll, is that the one you're talking about? Junie, she literally won the lottery. I'm like, oh my God, your cat is okay with literally everything. I couldn't believe it. I want that cat too. Doesn't one of your roomies own a cat? Yeah, I literally go into Myung's room all the time and I just take naps in her room nonstop. Lane, thanks for the 13 months. Thank you, thank you. I just take a bunch of naps in her room. And then, Myung, no! Myung, what are you doing? I have to end! Myung, Myung! Myung, come over. Come over. Pleased. Well, basically, hi, Raiders. On my way. Oh, Myung! Okay, I'll save it then. Damn, I have to go. This is awkward. I guess you have to stream for another hour. Dude, it's been a while since I've gone live and just talked for 2 hours straight. I feel like I don't do that very often. Her stamina. What? Short best, it takes you the 6 months? No, I said I would go to something today. That's why. You know? Play something. I don't have time. Yapper streams at this time. What can I say? Saturday night, dude. You can be a little late. I'm already late. I'm already late. And I'm not even there yet. You know what I mean? Saturday night. Damage takes the 3 months. Thank you. I started late knowing that, like, at the bare minimum, I would do 2 hours. Yeah. Yum, 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 yum. Hola, amiga. Hola. Mi nombre es Tina. Oh. Physical activity is the worst when your bones just hurt. No, I agree. When it's like not even muscle related, it's just your joints and bones. I'm like, oh, I agree. Oh. Mia. Guys, don't worry. She's just she's running. Oh god. Have you been working on your Spanish? No. I haven't been, but it's because it's kind of hard to unless somebody's with me all the time. Girl, where do you live? In the driveway or something? In the garage? My garage room. Let's see. ¿Qué pasa? Tú eres bonita como una gatita. Regalo. Te traje un regalo. I remember the TNT. the TNT. Wait, why are you beepo talking? let's see. What? Hello. 안녕. Hi.
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 Hey, yo.
Hi there. Oh, puppy. Hi, puppy. Hi, Pupward.
Popeye. Not the tilting up again.
Eh.
I can also tilt downwards.
Eh. I need to get another chair. Why did you raid me?
Well,
I told you I had to go.
Well, I thought we could have like a drinking party.
A drinking party?
Yeah. What do you know, dude? If you're going out, like, what if we just...
What is there to drink?
Drug. You know how it is.
Bro, I thought you said drug. I was like, drug! I was like,
sorry, ma'am? What the heck? She really said... Yeah, why not?
She said shrug.
Monka.
That's crazy.
That's wild.
Do we,
that's what you take me for.
I don't have anything to drink.
Oh, I can go grab it.
What are you going to grab? Is it a green bottle?
I could color it if that'll make you feel better.
I could.
Oh?
A little.
Oh? Okay. You want to hold him real fast?
Put him in my lap, yeah. Perfect. Oh my god, he's going to be sad the moment you're out of eyesight.
Nah.
Oh, he's honey. Oh, he's sweetie, big. You have no object permanence, do you? Stop! No, don't go anywhere. Oh my god. Okay. Oh my goodness. Hi, honey. We don't have any object permanence, huh? Oh, where's Miyoung? We'll never know. Oh, Navi. Where's my mommy? I don't know, honey. Yeah, little baby. Oh, God. Yeah, little chicken puppy. Tina, did you know the way we talk to animals is how you wanted to be talked to as a child? I don't know. Sometimes I call cats, like, I'm like, oh, I don't know if that's true. That feels like, yeah, where's your source? They're there. That's a rock fact. I call my cats dumb little idiots, parentheses endearing. No, literally. I feel like I wouldn't want to be called that as a child. Especially as a kid, I was like, I'm so intelligent and smart. I'm the smartest person I know. Like, dude, as a kid, I feel like I was a bit much. Not a thought behind those eyes. Oh, there's a couple thoughts. Why is she turning me? That was so quick.
Oh, well, bad news.
Oh.
It's not cold. Good news. A little shot glass.
Ta-da! Oh, 세상에. Wait. Wait, you could sit on that stool.
Okay.
Strawberry? I feel like the yogurt one's the best.
Okay, well, we didn't have any beds.
We don't. I organized the pantry. Oh, really?
I was like, surely we have one left.
Oh, my metal marshmallow.
Perfect.
Yay.
Well, now you have to confess one of your sins.
One of my sins?
Yeah.
You first? No?
She's too much of an angel. You know what?
No!
That's okay. My sin is that I'm too lazy.
That is so false. I used
my brain as an excuse to be lazy.
That's not true. I feel like sloth. Bottoms up.
You feel like what?
Oh, wait. Confess a sin. I'm lazy. I'm sloth.
What?
I'm way more sloth than you are. Yes.
No, you can't say that.
The way I watched you do the dishes and did absolutely nothing.
You took out the trash.
Multiple trashes, but who's counting? However. Dude, you know what I did say? I put the dishes away.
Oh my god! And she organized the pantry.
I did!
Look at her. She's popping off. I'm not gonna lie.
Oh, you know.
Cheers to roomies.
Roommates.
You know what? Not bad.
That used to be...
What's that?
A lot stronger to me.
Oh.
When I was a little younger. 21 younger.
Oh, well, God. So you're saying.
Huh?
That now you're used to it.
Dude, honestly, I feel like 12% is a whole lot of nothing, isn't it?
I agree. 12% is nothing?
Yes.
Yeah, it's true.
Well, take another one.
Yeah, you know what? You're right. Who
Aren't
said
you
that?
Supposed to be sleeping, bro?
Oh wait, that was Polish. I take it back. Never mind.
Isn't it like past your bedtime? youngster?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, it is actually.
My god. It's literally past man's bedtime. He has some nerve to be saying take a... Wait, it feels like fire. Why does it... It didn't
I
feel...
I thought you said this was easy.
I feel like it went down smooth, but I feel it in my stomach.
What did you eat?
I had the chicken quesadilla.
That was how many hours ago? That was like 6 hours ago.
I thought we were having dinner tonight, man. But I streamed. Yeah, wait, actually.
You can go grab a bite real fast.
I have pickles in the fridge.
Oh, you haven't.
Shit, Yoshi thinks the 25 months.
Let go of the pickles.
Dude, someone was pretending to be me with the whole like Twitter verification fiasco. And I was just, you know, I was like, interesting that you would impersonate me like this during Twitter's moment of weakness. You know who you are. I looked at it and they were like, just ate a pickle. When I just ate a pickle, I was like, how do you know?
Oh god, that is kind of scary though.
I was like, oh my god, read like a book front to back with the cover and all. I was like, that is uncanny.
Maybe you're impersonating them.
Maybe. I was like, get out of my walls. That's ridiculous.
Oh my god. I actually thought about changing my name and profile to either you or Ray. But I missed my chance.
You did. Dude, they gave them back, but it's like embarrassing because when you click it, it says that you bought it.
Yeah, it's okay if you bought it, man.
I didn't
Tina,
buy
it's
it.
It's okay, bro. It's fine. Just
I would never give my money to him.
Tina, it's okay to say you bought it. No one's judging.
I didn't give him my money, though. I didn't.
Okay. But, like, if you
It's
did,
so embarrassing. It says that I subscribed. I didn't subscribe.
Well, listen. Someone did, and it's obviously, you know, whoever owns the account. The way you, like, turned your head so fast.
Did not do that!
It's okay.
You know what? Another one. Oh my god, it says imported. Oh. I don't see it. It's right there. It's out of your field of vision. Come on. Come on. Can we panma? Is that okay?
Whoa.
Oh, no, it's not.
Whoa, she's crazy. You gotta cheers, though.
Oh, my bad.
Cheers! Cheers, chat, I guess. I keep saying shrug, and it's because Tina says shrug a lot, so I keep saying shrug. Shrug.
Alright.
Shrug.
Shrug.
It's just the way she said it, it's so natural, so now it's just like, shrug.
I don't know, shrug. Well, it's you know what it is? Sometimes I feel like I can't express myself over a voice call. Mm-hmm. So I have to tell you that I'm shrugging. I'm like, I don't know, shrug. like, how would you see that I'm shrugging in real life? Make a wish!
What?
Make a wish, Nabi.
Oh god, okay. What did he wish for?
He can't tell you, otherwise it won't come true.
Oh, okay. Well, I hope it comes true, man.
Oh my god.
Well,
it's 11:11. Yeah, I did.
Oh.
What do you think I closed my eyes for?
Did you?
I don't make a wish with my eyes closed open. I mean, my eyes open. Who makes wishes with their eyes open? That's weird.
Is that weird?
Well, yeah, because then the person that grants your wishes, whatever being it is, they have to know that you're talking to them.
And they only
So you close your eyes so that your spirit can talk to the person that grants them, obviously.
I'm taking notes. What else? What other wisdom?
Are you making your wishes with your eyes open, bro?
No, that would be weird.
So when you blow out your candles and you make a wish, you go...
Yeah, I blow it with...
And you make a wish when anybody can just look into your eyes? What if they see what you're wishing for through the intent of your eyeballs?
Then and they'll make it happen. They better. They know. They should do something about it.
No, because it goes like this. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Woo! And then you go. That's the wish. And then. That's what happens.
Really?
You close your eyes to make the wish and then you blow out the candles.
I swear I don't see anyone do that. They just go. They just blow it out with their eyes open. Right? Am I crazy for that?
Well, you definitely blow out the candles with your eyes open, because like otherwise you might miss. But you do close your eyes when you make the wish.
Oh. Maybe people just don't make wishes anymore.
I feel like blowing out candles on a shared cake is kind of disgusting. You know,
you're not wrong.
You ever
you're
think about
wrong.
It? Have you ever seen like those videos where it's like, where they show the germs that come out of the mouth? Like, especially during COVID, when people are sneezing, they would show us, like, the sneeze cam.
Yeah.
Imagine someone, like, blowing all over the cake that everybody's sharing.
Yeah. That is gross.
I try not to think about it.
But she does.
But I do a little. In the moment when someone is exhaling onto their birthday cake, all of a sudden, my vision goes into the negative mode, where it does like the blue person, you know, and then I see the germs go.
Oh my god!
And I'm like,
okay,
bone apple teeth, I suppose. Maybe I'll get a corner piece. Builds your immune system. Yeah, maybe.
Especially when there's like they have to do it multiple times. I'm like, wow.
Oh god.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
But you know, yeah, it probably does build up your immune system.
No, it does. It's like nail biters.
Huh?
You know, when people eat like little bits of like germs and stuff like that in their nails?
Yeah.
It's like a baby vaccine.
Yeah, no, I bet that's sick.
They're introducing small, tiny amounts of disease into their system.
Yeah. I bet that's really cool.
Foolish is a nail biter. And he never gets sick.
Wow.
I get sick a lot.
Sick? Well, maybe you have to start biting your nails.
No, I would never do that.
Oh.
I'm actually a chronic nail washer, and that's why I think they're so weak.
Okay, but if he never gets sick and he bites his nails, and you don't bite your nails and you get sick, who's really in the right there?
Well, maybe he is just more primal than I am.
Oh my god. Oh, okay. Well,
you know, he has natural survival instincts, whereas I just don't feel the need to do that. he has the primal urge to bite your nails.
You know, that was a thing, but things I learned.
Are you? He's giving up.
That's what do you mean? What do you mean giving
support
up?
Support yourself.
He trusts you.
Get up.
That's how much he trusts you. Leave him alone.
I'm trying to help him.
He's trying to live.
Ain't no way. I literally just saw Myung steal something from your room. Oh.
That's crazy.
Like what?
I didn't. Okay, would you trust him or me?
You.
Okay.
I feel like this is not a question.
Thank you. Oh, thank God. They're okay. Everything is balanced. Everything is balanced, restored in the world. Feels good now. Feels good.
He said, WTF.
That was good.
Listen. You've tricked me one too many times, Quackity.
One too many lies.
Anyways. Okay, oh. I'll pour this one.
Oh. Okay, I'll just sit properly until it's done.
Wait, we need, like, something to eat, though, to fill our tums. Could you get me the macarons from the fridge? Don't judge my fridge smell. I know it smells like dill pickle in there. I don't understand why they can't just make a new container. It smells like serious pickle in there, and it stresses me out. Did you smell that?
I wasn't gonna say anything.
Well, I'm gonna say it before you call me out on it.
I wasn't gonna say it.
It's embarrassing, I know.
But yeah, it does smell like pickle.
It does smell.
Oh.
Hold on. Oh, you've got something to say? Oh, hold on.
Oh, he's definitely saying something.
He's a pickle. Pickle smell.
As you should,
dude, honestly. The red ones are the best.
Red pickles?
No, oh, the macarons, oh. Bro. What are you talking
about? We talking about pickles just now. Were we not? I swear.
Well, we clearly have pickles that are no pickles in front of us.
Okay, fine.
Eat this one.
Oh no.
This is the best one.
I told you I don't like raspberry.
Oh yeah. But it's tart. Wait, which one did you have last time? Can I guess you had that one?
Do you like chocolate?
You do?
Yeah, I do.
Weird.
That's crazy that you would say that's weird. You're weird.
The red ones are obviously the best. Do you like pistachio?
I don't eat pistachio.
What about... Will you eat a chocolate one then?
Sure.
I don't fuck with chocolate ones.
Why?
Because it tastes like chocolate ice cream to me. And I just don't like that. I don't want that. What?
It's something...
I'm like, okay, when we go to like an ice cream store, are they saying chocolate, strawberry, vanilla? I will go for vanilla bean over like a chocolate.
That's fine.
Or strawberry, but it can't be like strawberry flavored. It has to have strawberry like in it, you know, like inside the ice cream.
Okay, but you just don't like chocolate ice cream.
Because it doesn't taste like chocolate to me. It tastes like the essence of chocolate, but not actually chocolate.
What chocolate ice cream are you eating?
After 2 years, I decided to unstand. Wait, I can change.
Guys, it's a work in progress.
I can change.
I can change her. It's okay. That's wild to me. That's actually crazy.
Oh my god. Uh-huh. Mmm.
This is not food.
Yes, it is. We're chewing. Are we swallowing? We are about to.
Okay.
In fact, I would argue that something like this, something that is very carby, flour-based, you would want that in your stomach when you're drinking. You know? I would prefer this over something like fruit, you know? Like a fleshy plant. Because I think when you drink, the best way to, like, make sure you're not sick the next day is if you have, like, a, like, potato, like, a carb or a starch. You know, something like that. Yeah.
Okay.
Are you not enjoying this?
No, this is great.
Someone said Myung looks like she's not enjoying it.
No.
Tell them you like it.
I like it. This is my good thing. Good. Tears of joy, really.
Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah.
That's really good.
Is everything alright?
Yeah, this is really good. Like, I just haven't had one that's this good before.
No, I understand. Especially for the price. It's such a bang for your buck. You know what I mean? So many of them. That's the best part about it. I'm like, oh my god. If I bought this many, it would cost well over $100 at a macaron store. But this, $16.99.
That is a good price.
That's a great price.
That is a really good
what a
price.
Steal. There's no pickle essence, right? No pickle essence.
Just the smell.
Mm-hmm. Tina's groceries cover all the essential food groups. Pickle and macaron.
I don't think that does.
It doesn't even smell like a pickle. It doesn't. It just smells like pickles in my fridge right now. Mm-hmm. Mm. What? They're acting like Facebook moms. In what way? In what way am I being a Facebook mom?
Yeah, elaborate.
Am I getting crumbs on your dog?
Oh my god. Navi.
I'm sorry.
Stand up for yourself. Don't just accept it. Do something about it. Hey. Oh my god. Okay. Doesn't care.
To be fair, he's unbothered. But I looked down and there's like red little flakes on it.
Robbie, hey.
I'm so sorry, dude. I should have eaten it in one bite. That's my bad. Oh my god. It's in your double coat. What the fuck? Oh god,
you know, it's okay. You always
want. I got them all out, actually.
It's a little hair moment for him.
Yeah.
You know how it is.
It looks like sprinkles. He's like a cupcake now.
He's a cupcake.
Yeah, he's a cupcake.
Is someone saying happy birthday? What is that?
Well,
like I'm hearing someone say happy birthday.
Who's saying happy birthday?
Never mind. I'm imagining it.
You are?
Yeah.
It's not your birthday, is it? It's not your birthday. You're a Scorpio.
It's not my birthday. It's just I thought I heard someone saying happy birthday, but no one's saying happy birthday.
You scared the shit out of me. Do you know those people that will go you'll spend the entire day with them? I'll be like, by the way, it's my birthday. Or they'll like briefly mention it. I'm like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Tell me it is your birthday a week in advance. That is ridiculous. I hate when people do that. What am I supposed to do? I need to prepare for your birthday.
Yeah, I would have never done that.
I would never do that. I hate when people... You can't do that. You're not allowed. Also, I can just look up your birthday on the internet. Also, I would like a pre-happy birthday hashtag trending for Miyoung, just so that I know it's her birthday a week prior so I can prepare.
So you want the week before to people to tweet out at me saying, pre-happy birthday for Tina.
No, for you.
Yeah, but like reminder for you.
No. That's awkward. But like for you, it's different.
Don't do it. Don't do it, guys.
Why do we never have like potatoes or something?
Well, you see... Yeah, cheers to that.
Yeah, damn.
Yeah, you're right.
Jesus. Why it tastes like that?
Great?
Great's a word.
Oh, he's just having the best time.
Yeah, with little crumbs on his body.
Okay, well... Face. He has a little face.
What day is your birthday?
Did you see what Foolish said about my birthday?
So it's in August.
What? Why did it come down to August?
It's in November.
What was the correlation to that? I'm just wondering. What was the correlation to August?
I thought about the date.
Yeah.
And so it's not. Got it.
Yeah.
Well, you could see why I said August.
I don't.
Well, there's dates in the chat, and if you just flip it, like one of them is August.
Oh.
And that's why I said August, because I kind of, I think,
it's a flipped thing.
I think I saw it and I was like,
it is flipped.
Oh, interesting.
It is definitely flipped, and it was wild.
That's September. Ooh, okay.
No one has ever.
Well, here's the time to come clean. I always mix up September and August. To me, they're the exact same month. They're the same.
Oh.
Try to tell me that September is different from August. They're very similar.
September babies rise up. Don't let her say that. Don't let her say it. Hey.
What's so different? Not the same. What's the difference between September and August?
And your own birthday.
That's true, but but the weather is like the same.
She says the weather.
Can I tell you what my problem is though?
What about June and July? Okay, sorry.
Don't you dare. July is the firework picture and June is the sunshine picture.
You never confuse the two?
June, and July. April has the umbrella picture, and March has the clover picture, and February has the heart, and January has the snowflake, and December has the Christmas tree, and November had the turkey, and October has the pumpkin. Now, what does September and August have? I don't even fucking remember, because they were leaves. They were different leaves.
Oh my god.
They were the same to me.
Oh my god.
Wow. May, I think, May was the flower. April showers bring May flowers. It's the rain from April that bring the flowers in May.
Oh my god.
And then, okay. And then June is just sun. And then July, fireworks. Your calendars didn't have these pictures?
No.
September and August just had leaves.
I didn't even know this was a thing. Is this a thing?
September is an apple.
Taking notes.
America education. Well, to be clear, I just solidified those months from the ripe age of 7, and that's the problem. Like, I never paid any more attention to them after that.
True.
Agreed. I'm a visual learner.
Same.
September is my birth month. Oh, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. And then in September, there's a picture of Shay. No? That's his month. Shayoshi in the chat.
Oh.
Yeah. May babies rise. It's almost our month. Never let her cook again. The kitchen's closed. She's cooking. The food is burnt.
Ooh. That's okay.
What happened?
Yeah, you know, that's okay. Isn't that right, Nabby? Oh, he's living the best life.
Bro, I got somewhere to be.
Oh, okay. Well, guess this is it then.
Guess and the crowd goes mild. That's a good one. I don't hate August babies. Listen, when I dislike a month, it's not because I dislike your birthday. Your birthdays are the exceptions. It's not even like I dislike the month. I just have a hard time distinguishing them because they're very, fall-coded. You know? They're all crisp autumn leaf-coded. Honestly, maybe... Yeah, see, I just never know which one comes first. I don't know why. I can just never tell.
Scrumptious Madonka Donk donated $10.
No one's judging. As an
August There's baby, a lot of things that I'm good 18. With, though.
Oh.
September and August, I just... Everybody has these things that they interchange in their head and they just can't get a hold of. I know it's not just me, but September and August are for me.
I would just like to preemptively apologize.
What did you steal?
No. What?
Oh.
What? I did. Okay, first of all. No,
I thought you were coming clean.
Steal.
My bad.
I steal, first of all. Second of all, I still have to apologize.
You well, don't like the macaroni?
Well, no. Not me. Like, I don't have to apologize. Like, Nabi should apologize. Apologize.
Hey, yo! Man drooled all over my pants. That is so nasty, little dude. I looked down and there's like wet marks all over.
Yeah, I saw it. I was like, ooh, better come clean now. That's not pretty.
You are drooling on my pants, bro. Dude, I literally, I saw him in the car one time and he just had the biggest like snot bubble. It was like comical. I was like, what in the world? I was like,
oh, don't expose it.
It was round like Whoa. In the cartoons. Man is drooling
That's
on
part of
me.
Your charm.
He's eepy. He's big chillin'.
It's part of your charm, isn't it?
Okay, fine. Pour another one.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Sick. She said another one. Agree.
Oh, dude, I love french fries. But I banned fries.
Why?
I banned them. Because I had them for dinner like 5 times in 1 week. That's disgusting. It's just too many. And not much nutritional value from like a fried potato, to be honest.
That's true.
You need more vitamins and minerals and protein, you know
Sweet
what I mean?
Potatoes, though.
Good stuff, really. Alright, Dad. Okay.
Yeah, that's all right. Pretty good.
Oh, hello, Amesy! Have you ever had poutine? Yeah, it's so good. I love any variation of, like, a loaded fry. You know? I love french fries so much.
But they're banned now.
I know, but the thing is, like, it's because I need to force myself to eat a little bit more, like, veggies and stuff, you know? Like, I can't... Oh, that one was kind of gross, bro.
Oh, you want it? That was it. No more. Cutting her off. Now.
You know, I'm very capable of drinking a whole 1.5.
Yeah, sure you are, Tina.
I am.
Tina the lightweight.
But People aren't saying that, are they?
They are.
Nobody said that before.
Well, they've been, and I've been shielding you from the fact. But now no. I'm saying it.
Not a single person has said that.
Well, yeah, yeah.
I actually remember you complimenting me.
No, I complimented the fact that you were down to drink, but you're kind of lightweight.
That's not true. It depends on how much I've eaten. Because I just thought about how much I didn't eat, and I'm like, you know what? I might be eating my own words right now. Golden rag. Thank you for the 2 months.
This is her after us sharing this, by the way.
I don't have food in my stomach to soak it up. It's different.
Same.
Do you know how to turn the AC on? It's so hot.
It's struggling.
It is blistering hot.
She's struggling.
You don't mean to tell me I have to you don't mean to tell me the AC central, is it? That is foul. Scrumptious Badonkadonk with a 5 gifted.
I'm sorry, what?
Thank you so much, man.
Who? Scrumptious Badonkadonk. He's quite charitable. In fact, I would. Scrumptious Badonkadonk is notorious for donating $10 in a parking lot. I feel like that's their specialty. They're like, I want a break from work right now. I'm like, all right, Scrumptious. At least that's what I remember. They said, what? I mean, you know.
Yeah, you know.
Oh, dude, I'm so warm.
Oh. Yeah, she's gotta eat, guys.
I have to go. I'm late. Like, beyond late. Stupid late.
Oh, well, I guess that's it then.
Oh, like God. That. Oh. Maybe it's because the dog was on me, bro. He's so toasty. He's like a furnace.
He's just a little hot, is all.
Yeah, he's a warm lad, dude.
Yeah.
Paxton, thanks for the 5 gifted.
Oh, that means you gotta stream for 5 more
thanks,
minutes.
Thanks, Paxton. Is that okay? You know what? I can do that.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
Easy clap. We got her, boys.
Easy clap. Five okay. 11:41. Okay. I'm gone like the wind.
Okay, noted.
Have you ever seen a red gone like the wind?
What does that mean?
It's gone with the wind, isn't it? That's why you're confused. Have you ever read or seen Gone with the Wind? She's like, oh, yeah, that one. Are you just going to not answer my question?
I'm like, is that what it's called?
Bro, you're wasted.
I'm not.
Lazy Beans, thanks for the 5 gifted.
Well,
thank you.
That means 5 more minutes.
Bruh. That's ridiculous. There's no shot. I still need to get dressed. I'm wearing sweats.
Oh.
I'm not doing a subathon. Yeah, like, that's ridiculous.
Well, I mean,
I don't even like the way my hair looks right now. Oh, God.
Cute.
I did it on stream.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Cute.
We were just having little talks, and I was braiding it on stream. I don't want this here anymore.
Oh, okay.
Could you put it back?
Oh, God,
and then I'll take your dog.
Oh, okay.
Mine!
I guess you can have another swatch on the hands. Wow, that smells like pickle.
Bro, stop talking about my pickle fridge, dude. I think I need, like, another fridge specifically meant for, like, pickled items like kimchi and stuff.
True. True.
You know that song?
We lost her.
We'll play it. Fine, we'll play it.
Okay, play it.
You're not gonna be able to hear it.
Oh, okay. Well. Oh, are you playing it?
Yeah. Or. Hold on.
Oh, she has it. Okay.
Maybe. Okay.
Okay.
Oh, wait. It's not even going to play like that, though. Hold on. Stop. Sound. Like this. Okay.
Okay.
Bless you, bro. Bless you, brother. One. Can you guys hear it still? I'm going to get DMCA. You know you can't hold me forever. I didn't sign up. Oh, you can hear it? Disgusting.
Oh, disgusting.
Okay, wait.
Waiting.
We should have like a team extreme. Chicken and beer.
Ooh, the beer tastes bad.
It tastes great with chicken.
Does it really?
Yeah.
Okay.
You have to think in your brain, I love this.
Oh.
And then you'll like it.
Okay. I could do that.
That's how I got myself to like so many foods. I go like this and I'm like, scrumptious! And then my brain's like, actually, yeah, like the notes, the cherry oak barrel, I get it.
Yeah.
All of a sudden, it makes sense.
Yeah.
And I'm like, yes, you understand. And then it's, yeah, you just gaslight yourself.
Okay, I could do that.
And that's how I grew to like beer. I'm like, oh, I can understand how, like, the fatty flavors of this double fried chicken, like the grease, the savory umami flavors. All of a sudden, the grease and the fat is cut with the sharp, refreshing, you know, beer. These ales, these hops, you know? And you're like, yum!
Yeah! Okay. Can't wait.
All right. Bye, guys.
All right.
She's lost it.
Yeah, we lost her. We lost her a while ago, but that's okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Here, let's raid. Yeah. Yeah. This is a good one. You agree with this?
Yeah.
Of course we do.
Of course we do. Hearts. How do you do a heart? That's so difficult.
But it's so crisp.
Doesn't this look like a uterus?
Not if you do it right. The fuck? She said, love you guys. Love you guys so much. Make sure to donate your eggs at the next egg bank.
Oh my god. I never thought I'd get flamed like that. Wow, it's wild, okay.
My bad, I went hard in the fate. And that's an accident. Alright, make sure... This is why I don't drink on stream. I feel too silly goofy.
That's great though. We love it's not. Silly goofy.
It's not.
Do we not love silly goofy?
It's for the party's eyes only. Tina. No, too goofy.
Silly goofy.
Too goofy. Dude, I am sweating so much.
Yeah, it's kinda hot.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. Sweater. Guys, say hi to Celine. Tell her you love her. Me and Me Young's and Foolish's chat.
Weird. It just doesn't look like a heart.
Okay. Middle finger.
Oh.
But do that.
Oh. Okay.
Okay.
That
and then
feels wrong.
Do these args, like two args, like this.
Right.
Middle finger.
That looks like a uterus, what? Doesn't it?
Bro! Make these straight.